Hey everybody, Adelman here. So it is March 15th. I officially shut Animal World Experience down, the traveling part at least, down. Yesterday was my last day. So today I'm no longer working, which is a big problem. But it's what I have to do to be proactive for the safety of myself, my family, my loved ones. So my message to you guys is, I feel in the pit of my stomach that things are about to get really crazy, really, really bad. And I'm not sure exactly what that means or the time frame for this, but I feel it. Let me close the windows so you can hear me better. A lot of you only know me from doing my animal programs with Animal World Experience. However, I own two businesses. My other business is, surely enough, survival skills and preparedness skills, prepping. You know, I teach how to prepare, how to power your house, power electronics in unconventional ways, how to store food, how to purify water, what plants you can eat, how to make medicine, how to make your own weapons, archery tackle, hunting, camouflage techniques, communications, all that stuff. That's what I teach, basically. And I have an associated Instagram with that also, and also an associated YouTube channel. And that business is called Animal Man Survivor, because everyone calls me the Animal Man, right? So I just made it Animal Man Survivor. That YouTube channel just hit 10,000 subscribers. So I've been posting a lot on there. I've been filming a lot of videos about this virus. I haven't gotten a chance to post them all, but I'm going to start posting them. And the stuff on there, if you follow me at all, if you've met me, if you know me from work, you know, I care about you guys. I love all you guys. If you want to hear from me about what I know, about what's going on, and things that I know that can help you, please go there. I also have, if you're interested, to help support my family, because we have no income except for, you know, online, my online income, which is minimal at this point. If you want to help support us, aside from the YouTube, I've also got an Animal Man Survivor Patreon, which is $1 a month, but you get to see the videos up there first, and there's exclusive content on there for you too. So if you're interested in that, I'll put a link, and that's awesome. That's cool. If not, check out the YouTube. It's free. And I'm going to be putting some stuff on there, how to make antivirals, two different, my top two different favorite ways to make antivirals, stuff about making your own gas masks and N95 masks, and just all kinds of helpful stuff, security stuff, food storage and food acquisition. Because of that business, and all my contacts, you know, I'm in contact via cell phone, text messaging, email, and other ways all the time with other preppers and other instructors and other people who work in this industry. And I've been having a lot of conversations with people about what's going on, people all over the country, and I've been hearing a lot of scary things about what's going on there and then what they've heard is going to happen. One of my buddies called me, and then we were texting back and forth this afternoon, and he said that he had someone tell him that this is somebody that works for the state, saying that they're planning on shutting down all of the retail stores very, very soon. I don't know how soon, maybe as soon as tomorrow, and that'll be all retail except for grocery and pharmacy. And you might be like, oh, well, so I don't need to run out and go to the grocery store yet. Yeah, you do, because if, I'm not saying this is true, but if this does happen, once people realize that this has happened and everything is shut down, the only things that are going to be open are the grocery and pharmacies. People are going to be like, oh, crap, it's not going to be long before those are going to be shut as well. And the panic buying is going to get that much worse. And it won't matter that they're open, because you know what? The shelves will be cleared, and they're going to start having problems with resupply. So it won't even matter that they're open. Okay? So you need to get what you need now. Please, please, please get it now. Take this seriously. This is me warning you. If I'm wrong, worst case scenario, if I'm wrong, you have extra food for your family. Okay? And if I'm wrong, I don't care. I get up and make a fool of myself in front of kids for a living, guys. I don't care if I'm wrong. But I just want, I'm hoping that I'm able to help you guys, help somebody, you know, because it's what I do. So please take this seriously. Check out my YouTube, and I've got, I think, about 300 videos up on there, all kinds of stuff that's helpful in this type of situation. And I've been preparing for something like this to happen for over 10 years at this point. So I've been in this for a long time. And you know, you think that someone that's been in this as long as I am, that I'd be in less shock and more prepared right now. And I'm more prepared than 99.9% of people, but I'm not comfortable with my level of preparedness. It's the kind of thing where you kind of never are, I guess. But, man, a lot of people are going to need help, and I'm not going to be able to help. They need to help themselves, and the time to do it is now. I don't know if people realize how big of a deal this is for me to shut my business down. I mean, I am the sole income for 5 people. So it's a big deal. And, you know, I make money off of YouTube a little bit, off of Patreon. I make it from Amazon a little bit, but not a lot, guys. Not enough to make a real dent in the bills. Normally what I do is I take a lot of that money, and that becomes like my monthly prepping budget, honestly. But that's all we're going to have now. So Animal World Experience is closed for traveling shows for the foreseeable future. I don't know when. I'm hoping just a few months or something. Well, I really don't know. You know, I have asthma, and I've had Lyme disease 3 separate times, so I kind of put myself in the higher risk category if I got this thing. So I'm out now running errands. I just need to pick up a few more things, and then we are prepared to shelter in place for as long as it takes. And the longer we are in place, my tactics are going to change, basically. I don't know how else to say it. How I do everything, how we prepare food is going to change. How I acquire new food is going to change. You know, we're going to have every year I have a huge organic garden. It's going to be bigger. It's like going to be a garden on steroids this year, and we're already working on it. So, yeah, check out the YouTube, guys. I'm also putting this video on Facebook. I need this message to get out to everyone that I know, to make sure that I've said my piece. And if you guys choose to ignore me, choose to ignore it, and that's on you. But I've done what I feel in my heart I need to do to warn everybody how serious this is, how serious things are about to get. One of my contacts that I know for the prepper community told me that in the shop that he works in, all the ammunition is selling out. And I believe it, because it's happened before. Why would that be, you may ask? Because people are scared that people aren't going to have enough resources and they're going to start looting. That's why. That's why. Which is scary as hell. So, check out my YouTube, Patreon if you want. Follow me on Instagram, both of my Instagrams, guys. And also you can follow me on Facebook, too. I'm on Facebook as well. So, all right. I wish all the best to you and all your families. And I really hope that this is not going to be as bad as I fear it is. But I, as far as people go, I tend to be fairly in tune with my instinct and my gut feelings. And this virus thing and the situation that I have been seeing unfolding has been tugging at me harder and harder and harder and harder. And now I feel like we're right on the edge of it getting really, really horrendous. So that is it. I'm just going to rant on forever if I don't turn this damn camera off.